I can't even have food at my house.
They don't know that I've dug like 1,250 holes to pay for my race car.
It'll be $1,300 holes after today.
Right.
Yeah. See, we're all that stuff back there in the back, chainsaw and concrete and digging utensils.
We do that when we get off work.
Yeah.
We go dig holes.
That's how we fund our race car addiction.
You'll see, though. We'll show you.
Last but not least, I want to thank me. I want to thank me for believing in me. I want to thank me for doing all this hard work. I want to thank me for having no days off. I want to thank me for never quitting.
You videoing now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, a lot of people think that we're just loaded because we got that big toter and we got fast cars.
If we was loaded, I wouldn't have dug him holes.
I'm here to tell you, it's like 90 today, and we just dug a 3-foot hole and put that post in it, and then we cut up this asphalt over here and put another 3-foot post in, and then another 3-foot hole around the corner. So
work hard, play hard.
Yeah,
1,000 horsepower car, you gotta dig holes.
Wouldn't that be nice if we didn't have to, though?
You got to, though.
Oh. I'm tired of this, Grandpa.
That's too bad. You keep digging.
Okay, well, after we get done with all the digging and setting those posts in the concrete, we let them set up for a few days or whatever, and then we have to go back and set the gate. That's a gate back there. It's upside down right now, but that's kind of the idea of what it is. We set a lot of wildlife gates and fancy gates and whatever people want across their driveway to keep people out. So we get off work of the evenings and on weekends, and we go set gates. That's how we fund our race cars.